Now we will discuss how to generate the wave functions. So, as we know that the recursion relation is a j plus 2, and this is 2j plus 1 minus k over j plus 1 j plus 2 in aj. We derive that n is equal to 2k, that k is equal, to 2n minus 1, where n was equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So, we will have our equation. This AJ, the recursion relation, will convert. If for k I put 2n minus 1, so minus minus plus, and it will give me, this is 2n plus 1. So when plus 1 minus 2n minus 1, 1 1 will cancel, and I will get minus 2 and n minus j divide by j plus 1 into j plus 2 and a j. Now we will have to keep in mind that for each value of n, we are having a set of a j's. So all the coefficients, we are having a set of it. Let's start with for n equals 0, we can start from j equal to 0. So when n is 0 and j starts from 0, then only one term which is a naught will survive in this series, while rest of all the terms will be equal to 0. So let's see here. For n0, j0, we will have a 2 equals n is 0, j0. So on the numerator we are having 0, and here we are having 2, and this is a naught. This tells us that for a naught non-zero, a 2 equals a 4 equals a 6, and all the even series is equal to 0. So only one term survives, so we can say that h of xi, h naught, is equal to a naught, while rest of all the terms are equal to 0, and we are having psi naught of xi equals h naught of xi, so this is a naught e to the power minus xi square over 2. And this resembles our previous equation for wave function that we derived. Psi naught of x, if we put for xi x, was m omega over pi h bar 1 over 4 e to the power minus m omega over 2 h bar x square. So this resembles, if we find the normalization constant a naught, as well as we put for xi the value of in terms of x, then we will get back this equation. Similarly, if I try that for n equals 0 and j equals 1, so what I will get in this equation, j equal 1, so I will get a 3, and a 3 is equal to n is 0, j is 1, so it is minus 1 minus 1, so this is equal to 2, and divide by 2 here and 3 here, 6, and this is a 1. And this comes out to be not possible, because A3 comes out to be 1 over 3 times A1. A1 is supposed to be less than A3, and this situation is not possible. So we will have to go to other values of n. So for n equals 1, we can start with g equals 0, but we will again get the even series, so we want even we have already found. So for g equals 1, I want to find the coefficient in the odd series. So this will be a3 when j is 1, a3 is equal 1 minus 1, so it is 0 divided by this is 1, so 2 and 3 will make 6 in A1. This implies that A1 is non-zero, while all the other odd coefficients like A3, A5, A7 and so on are equal to 0. So only A1 survives. And this will imply that H1 of Xi, A1 Xi, is from our previous. So, this implies that Psi1 of Xi is equal to A1 Xi e to the power minus Xi square over 2. And this also resembles our one calculation. If we find the normalization constant Xi here, so x will come here and then e to the power minus x square. So this also resembles, we can go on calculating this, that for each value of n we can have a set of ages. Some are possible, some are not possible, so we can go on with this. While the generalized form of psi n of x is m omega over pi h bar 1 over 4, and we will introduce now the Hermite polynomials. So this is 1 over 2n n factorial, and h n, the Hermite polynomials of xi, and e to the power minus xi square by 2, where we know the value of xi. The Hermite polynomials can be found with the help of the Rodrigues formula, that hn of xi is equal to minus 1 to the power n e to the power z square e to the power xi square d over d xi to the power n e to the power minus xi square over 2. So this is called the Rodrigues formula, and with the help of the Rodrigues formula we can find the Hermite polynomials. These are like the Legendre polynomials, and the Rodrigues formula and how it is derived and how it helps the Legendre polynomial as well while solving the Laplace equation. We cover all this thing in classical electrodynamics. So classical electrodynamics, we will resume the classes of classical electrodynamics soon, so over there we will cover such calculations. But from this formula we can easily find the Rodrigues, the Hermite polynomials. H0 of this is equal to 1, H1 of xi, the Hermite polynomial second, is 2 xi, H3 xi is equal to 4 xi square minus 2 h. This is h2, and h3 xi is equal to 8 xi cube minus 12 xi. And so on, we can go on calculating them. Okay, I have plotted the wave function, the probability of this and the probability of a very high number of the state. Now, I am sorry for my poor drawing, but I have tried my best. One can consult the figure, the same figure inside the book for clear understanding. So here, when I plot psi n of x, as we have plotted in the previous lectures as well, this is psi naught of x. So psi naught of x is even and it is symmetric about the origin, and this one is psi 1 of x. Now, as we see that some portion of it is going out of the potential, because inside the potential we were having some other terms as well, and due to that reason the wave functions are getting out of it for the other terms. Here psi 1 of x is an odd function because it is not symmetric along y-axis on both sides. This one is positive and this one is negative. When I plot psi 2 of x, then psi 2 of x is also even because it is symmetric on both the sides along y-axis. It is an even function. Now, if I take the probability of this are the psi mod square, then all the negative portions will convert into positive and it will rise a little bit compared to the magnitude here and will become sharp as well. Here we can see that this is psi naught mod square. This is psi 1 mod square and psi 2 mod square. When this one is squared, only this, the negative, will come up. But as we square this one, then the amplitude of these two is high compared to this one. So it will come in the middle and it will go like this. So as we go to higher and higher number, then this and this will go up while this will become less in magnitude. And here we can see for psi 100, if we plot through computer, then we see that the first one and the last one here, they are very high while the rest are getting lower, lower, and then they are reciprocating themselves here. So for the psi 100, we are having the probability or the psi mod square like this. This is the probability density. So this way we can plot our wave functions for the harmonic oscillator, and with this we have completed the section 2.3 of the harmonic oscillator, and in the next lecture we will come with the free particle.